is barred.
Lunadad now!
the mountain itself. If there's an entrance here, it'll be nearby.
Ahead, another orc warband.
What are they doing? Studying the ground?
There must be something wrong.
Look, there's a door.
Skirmish here. The tracks are hard to read, but it appears the fighting carried on into the mountain. Someone was here before us. There was a fight here very recently.
The bodies. They're dwarves.
This one lives still.
Well then, come on, you scum. Finish it! You're not orcs.
Why are you here? What were you attempting?
We seek a weapon. We must find it. Use it. Stop the orcs.
What is this weapon? Where can we find it?
Dwarf weapon. In the stone. Nordri has the key. Find them. Help them. Please.
Your friends, where are they?
Went on. Can't say where. Now. Find them. They need...
Who or what is Nordenbad?
He will speak no more. He is dead.
But it sounds like there may be more like him around here somewhere.
Yes. They're searching for some sort of weapon. Come, we must try to find them.
It pains me to leave fallen dwarves to these accursed orcs, but we have no choice. Maggots, teeming in the corpse of once great Gundabad.
They delight in marring the works of others, and twisting them to their own foul purpose.
These caverns echo with the hammer blows of 1,000 orc smiths.
Servants of the enemy, beware!
Recognize these signs. A ranger has left a hidden cache here.
Thank you.
He's a Dunedain now!
Thank you.
part of the enemy's war. They forge weapons and armor to equip the hordes gathering here.
They're making more than that. Can't you smell it? The same blasting powder used against us at Fornost. There must be a huge store of it here.
Then let us destroy the gears. Perhaps we will slow their war mills.
enemy, beware!
Follow dwarves. We must be close.
We won't find out standing here.
This is it! Quick climb! Up you go! Nordring! Nordring.
There are too many orcs. We'll never hold them long enough.
Maybe not, but we can try.
Well then, come on, you filth!
Baruch Kazar!
Katana Menu!
We're friends! We're here to help you!
We must work together to overcome these odds.
There's a mounted crossbow over there.
Man the mounted crossbow!
We'll hold them off! Kazar! Kazar! Keep them away from the weapon! At all costs!
Like this, but I'm mighty glad to see you all the same.
We might say exactly the same. What are you doing here?
We've come to activate an ancient weapon.
With luck, it'll kill a lot of orcs.
What sort of weapon?
You'll see.
Once activated, it'll take some time to do its work.
Aye, and it's sure to bring a lot more orcs down on us, too.
No time for dilly-dallying. Go ahead and use it.
We'll hold off the orcs.
Thank you.
mountain is coming down!
Aye, a good deal of it anyway. Just as we hoped.
You knew this was going to happen?
It's what we came here for.
We had to strike this blow if our people are to survive. I'm heartily sorry for getting all of you killed as well.
I don't think we need to worry about death just yet. Look!
Durin's beard!
This is a day I'll not soon forget. I've seen a few things in my time, but I've not flown on an eagle's back till today.
Well, now that it's a bit easier to talk, let me thank you properly for saving our lives and bid you welcome to Nordenbad, our home.
Nordfri's father, the Lord Gorin, will want to speak with you. Nordfri's gonna head to report on the Gundabad raid and to tell him about everything you did for us.
We're grateful for the welcome, but in the rush of battle and our escape, I don't believe we actually caught your name.
Oh, confound me for an old fool. Bruni, son of Bane, at your service and your family's. I'm captain of the Nordenbad Guard and a servant of Lord Gorin.
What can you tell me about your lord?
Gorin's a great leader. He'd have to be to hold Nordenbad together for so long, surrounded by enemies and starved for basic necessities as we are. There's not a dwarf here who wouldn't lay down his life for him.
At your instruction, the Eagles brought us east for many leagues, over many high mountain peaks. Where are we now, exactly?
Aye, it's east you've come. Clean over the Misty Mountains and along the length of the Grey Mountains. You've left the lands of Eriador behind. You're on the northern edge of the land of Rovanion now.
Why did you lead your warriors against Mount Gundabad?
We keep a careful watch on the orcs in the mountains. We saw them gathering in large numbers at Gundabad. We had reason to believe they were preparing to move against us here. We didn't like our chances against that many orcs, but we knew about the hidden weapon at Gundabad. So Nordfri and I led a small force there to use it against them.
You undertook that mission believing you would not return.
Aye, every dwarf was a volunteer and knew he wouldn't be coming back.
But you said Nordfri is Gorin's son. He let his heir undertake such a mission.
He didn't have a choice. After a lifetime of lecturing the lad about his duty to his people, there was no way Gorin could say no when Nordfri volunteered, much as he'd have liked to.
What can you tell us of the device you used to collapse the ceiling at Gundabad? I've never heard of such weapons.
It was an ancient defense made by the dwarves who delved Gundabad long ago. Nobody understood the qualities of stone better than the dwarves of old. And they knew that just the right sound can cause solid stone to split. They used that knowledge to build a defense against any enemy who might force their way past the gates of their home.
But Mount Gundabad has been an orc home for centuries. How did you know about this weapon?
Aye, it's been in the hands of the orcs for many a year, but not straight through. I was only a lad when my people fought a great war against the orcs. My father helped sack Gundabad. He was one of the stoneworkers who found the weapon. It made a big impression on him, and he told me the tale so many times I was sure I could find the thing and use it against the orcs.
But how could you be certain it would still function after all those centuries?
We didn't. The whole thing was a gamble. Luckily, it paid off.
Am I correct in guessing that you might have a similar defense here?
Some things are best left secret.
Do you think the orcs will follow us here to Nordenbad?
Escaping on eagles like we did will throw them off the trail a bit, but it won't be long before they realize it was a group of dwarves that hit them first, and that'll get them thinking about us here. It's not like they're not thinking about Nordenbad anyway, but I'll let Gorin tell you more about that.
We would be pleased to speak with Lord Gorin.
Just make your way past the door as you see yonder and you'll find him within. The guards have been instructed to let you pass.
I suspect I'm the first man to see the inside of these halls.
I am certain I'm the first elf to do so.
guess that such a place still existed in these mountains.
Here, sire, are those I spoke of. Allow me to present a kinsman, Farron of Erebor, and also Andriel and Eridan, his companions. We succeeded in our task, and I live to tell of it, thanks only to their aid.
You are most welcome here, kinsman, and no less so your companions, be they man, elf, or eagle. Welcome all to Nordenbad, last hall of the Longbeards in the Grey Mountains. You have returned to me, my son and my oldest friend, whom already I mourned as lost. For this, you will forever have my gratitude and the hospitality of these halls. Know that this is not something lightly given, for never before have we allowed any but our own folk to pass these gates, and no eyes have gazed upon the hidden lake of Azan.
We are glad to have been of service. All free folk should stand together in these dark days.
May I ask how it was you happened to be in so unlikely a place as Mount Gundabad? One does not go lightly into so foul a pit.
We were hunting a black-hearted servant of the enemy. He goes by the name of Agendaur.
Agendaur? We are familiar with that one. Curse his black heart.
He appeared before our gates some weeks past and called us to parley. In the name of Sauron the Great, so he said.
A parley? What did he ask of you?
He demanded that we yield ourselves up to the mercy of Sauron. As if there was any mercy in the Dark Lord.
He lays claim to Nordenbad, telling us if we turn over our halls and riches without a fight, our lives will be spared, and we will be free to seek a new home elsewhere.
Of course, we would have nothing of that. When we defied him, he grew wrathful, threatening us with the fiery doom that overtook our ancestors.
What could he want with Nordenbad? I do not mean to offend, but these halls are very remote. Is it wealth he seeks?
Nay. Nordenbad provides for our needs, but never have we considered it rich, save in beauty.
I fear he may have allied himself with the dragon Urghast, who dwells in these parts. With such a beast at his command, we would have little hope of resisting him.
A dragon? But could even Agendaur command the allegiance of a dragon?
Perhaps not on his own account, but if he speaks for the Dark Lord, even Urghast would think twice before offending him.
Nah. Dragons are wicked creatures, and their greed knows no bounds. Agendaur only has to name the right price.
Maybe we should go after this dragon before he comes after us.
Well, destroy Urghast? If only it were that simple. The attack on Gundabad would be a peaceful stroll around the lake in comparison. Nay, if it were so easy to slay dragons, there would be many more dwarves still dwelling in these mountains.
Urghast has never taken notice of us before. We rather hoped it would stay that way.
I have heard it said it does not pay to leave an eyed dragon out of your calculations if you live near one.
We can't let Agendaur have such a beast under his command.
Agreed. Where can we find Urghast?
You do not lack for courage, I will grant you. Yet we know not where the dragon dwells. No dwarf has discovered his lair and lived to tell of it.
Perhaps Radagast knows this secret, or can discover it. Seems there is little that happens in Wilderland that escapes his notice.
Who is Radagast?
Radagast the Brown. He is a wizard, a master of birds and beasts. He keeps to himself mostly, but he's a decent enough sort. As long as you mean no harm to the wild creatures he befriends.
He dwells within the forest of Mirkwood, away to the south. Perhaps your companion Belarang would know where to find him. For it is said that Radagast is a friend to the Lord of Eagles himself.
Then we should travel to Mirkwood. I am certain we will learn something of value speaking with Radagast.
Indeed. But before you set out, please accept a token of our gratitude. Seek out my steward Galar. I have instructed him to open our vaults to you. I believe you may find something within that will be of service in the days ahead.